RLS Rapid Locking System, the original patented proven refrigerant press fittings. Just follow these 10 easy steps to properly install RLS press fittings. For detailed instructions, refer to the RLS installation guide available on our website. Start by visually inspecting the fitting and O-rings for obvious signs of damage or debris due to handling. Then check the tube end for deep scratches, incise marks, or other defects, and cut them off if present. Use the provided or similar tube cutter that is not worn or damaged to ensure a clean cut. Saw cuts are not recommended, but if necessary, ensure a straight cut and proper tube prep. Place the provided deburring tool over the cut end of the tube and rotate it back and forth 5 to 7 times to remove any residual burrs from both the outside and inside of the tube. Use the abrasive pad provided or a similar pad, sandcloth or sandpaper, to clean the end of the tubes to be joined. The surface should be free from oxidation, dirt and debris, and appear shiny and bright. Use the RLS depth gauge to determine the proper insertion depth of the tube based on the tube diameter. Mark this point using a permanent marker. Push the fitting onto the tube until you feel a hard stop or until the insertion marks are aligned with the ends of the fitting. Now get the tool ready for use. Press the locking pin and rotate it 45 degrees to release. Slide the appropriate size jaw over the tool's head and depress the locking pin until it clicks. Then, slide the charged battery onto the tool base. It is recommended to cycle the tool by pressing and holding the trigger until the cycle is completed. Open the jaws by pressing at the base. Then, align the jaws between the groove on the fitting and the flare at the end. If you align the bottom portion of the jaw, then the top portion will follow. The jaw should not be positioned directly over the groove containing the O-ring. Press and hold the trigger on the press tool and continue to hold it until the tool completes its cycle. Open the jaws and remove the tool from the fitting. The jaws will not open until the cycle is completed. If using a 1 3/8 inch fitting, you must also make a second crimp after rotating the tool at least 60 degrees from the first crimp. This extra step is only necessary when using 1 3/8 inch fittings. Now check for the RLS witness mark within the crimp band. If the RLS mark is not visible, the fitting must be re-crimped or removed and replaced. Then use the provided RLS crimp gauge to confirm the finished crimp band diameter. Find the proper size slot on the gauge and slide it over the crimp band. It should fit snug but completely over the band. If not, the fitting is under-crimped and must be re-crimped. A permanent mechanical joint has now been made. For more information on RLS press fittings, visit rapidlockingsystem.com.